Hello everyone! Today I'm gonna help everyone familiarize themselves with the developer environment of the RTL8762. This is the content I will go over, which includes the structure of folders, an introduction to the hardware, to the software, and to the structure of the documentation directory. Finally, we provide a very simple demo to show you how the Bluetooth chip works. Well, first of all, we have to get the information. There's a way we get the information. realmcu.com. Everyone go to this website and log in. Click support button and click on document button. Here's all our information. Scroll down, it's all information you will use later. Well, I have already downloaded all documents. Okay, there are three folders here. They are C, D, E. Today I'm gonna talk about the structure of these folders. The structure of D and E are the same as C. After explaining the structure of 8762C, then the remaining two structures can be inferred for yourself. It's all the same. Okay, let's start with this catalog. Well, first of all, this directory contains three PDFs. As the theme implies, the datasheet is an overall introduction to our chip. So, this is the first folder, which contains all our chip functional, which are both in Chinese and English. Then, we will introduce these PDFs in detail later. Next, in the EVB folder, explaining how to use our development board. In the HDK folder, it includes a schematic diagram and layout, which can be helpful for everyone in designing their first product. So, what about MP and the tools? This includes our debug tool, OTA upgrade tool, MP packaging tool, burning tool, and RF test tool. In the quickly start folder, we can get FAQ and the topics that I'm currently covering. Yeah, what I'm talking about right now is what's in the quickly start guide. Then FAQ is for the problems that occur during regular development. These common problems encountered are listed in FAQ file. Then, SDK folder contains projects in the development process, the Angel OTA project and the CARE project. Also, there's GCC project. Then, there are two images here, a room patch image and a secure boot image. These two images should be burned into the chip when we are making the demo. Okay, this is our old directory structure. After you download it, you can go through them one by one. Then let's introduce the hardware now. Open this EVB folder. We mainly want to see what's on this board. And how to wire it. Then let's take a look at the top view of this development board. There are yellow connectors here. So when you receive development board, it won't have these connectors. Then the things we have to pay attention to are powering after getting the board. That's to say the three connectors for 8, 9, 10 have to be connected. for a successful burning, these connectors we have to connect so we can burn chip. These four connectors can be disconnected because it's connected to four LEDs. If you don't need to use LED, then these can be ignored. But the top five connectors, 8, 9, 8, 10, and 3 have to be connected. It must be connected so that you can burn chip. Then on our development board, it also includes some peripherals. The four LEDs mentioned earlier. Here, this is a GCC sensor and the six buttons on the right side. One of these six buttons is the reset button. The other buttons are connected to the daughter board GPIO one by one. A button corresponds to a GPIO instead of matrix keyboard. Then this is our development board. As for some details on the development board, such as these pins, it's related to the chip, so you can read this document by yourself. Take a look at the detailed introduction then for today's video. I won't explain it all to you. There will be a more detailed video later and a targeted video, which will tell you these details. Okay, then let's close this document. Then we will talk about the structure of the software. If we want to develop, then first of all, is the ability to compile source code and generate an image that can also be burned into the chip. This is our software category. First of all, when it comes to SDK, our SDK is a CARE project. And what about GCC SDK? It corresponds to the GCC project. After you click in, you can see a familiar developer environment. If we want to boom, then go to the MP and tools folder. It includes MP tools, a tool for burning, and then MP pack tool, which is a packaging tool. For real tech product, it needs many people to develop it. So a lot of images will be generated, such as those in the SDK, like room patch and the secure boot. Where having the many images for the factory to produce is inconvenient. So we need this pack tool to pack into a single image and then give it to the factory for producing. Then the debug analyzer, this tool is for long capture. Okay, so these tools help us to burn the chip. Well, there's an OTA APK here. This tool is installed on the Android phone. It's for air upgrades. It's also a tool. Okay, so our video today is for you to take a look at what's under this directory. Next, we will show you a demo to see a basic usage scenario of the Bluetooth chip. I will make a demo for you. Okay, now let's do it.